there are definitely a lot of songs that I had been writing, especially the ones that I was playing today. I've been writing during the band. I've been writing songs, you know, as long as I can remember, more or less, you know. And it's kind of the same thing when I look at Joe's band, The Damn Things or whatever, where he was writing all those songs. He would play me those songs as like demos for Fall Out Boy. He'd be like, "Oh, what do you think of this part?" And I'm like, "Yeah, it's awesome, but it's a like hard rock song, you know, like whatever." And that's kind of the thing, is that there were songs that I would write, and the way the band worked, my lyrics weren't really, it just didn't fit, you know, and so that was kind of one of the things. So there's plenty that I will be playing that are pretty old. Some predate the band, actually. So one of the things on this record, again, like I was saying, the second time around when I had more of a plan of what to do, I really wanted to emulate a lot of really ornate hip hop production, drum stuff, whatever, kind of like 90s Timbaland stuff. I really like that level of syncopation, but you can't play that. You can't actually play that, like whatever, it's all programmed usually. So one of the things I wanted to do was play it. But that meant that rather than sitting at a kit and playing a lot of these things, I had to go one at a time, you know, and do my bass drum rhythm and my weird hi-hat rhythm. And so I would have to sequence that initially to start, and then I would have I like a lot of program synths. I don't really like to play a lot of synthesizer. So, and there's a certain degree of program synthesizer on a lot of this record. So those would be usually the bed, and then over all of that would be where, you know, the guitar and the bass and my horns and my and analog keyboards or something, or you know, pianos and that kind of stuff would come in. So but usually drums and keyboards is where it started. As far as, you know, yeah, the comparative visibility of my solo act versus the band, it's kind of a shame that the two have to ever be related to each other. You know, it's that thing of, it's only a solo act because I was in a band. If I were never in a band, it would just be my record, you know, I'd just be me and we wouldn't talk about it, you know, but I was in this band and I don't know that I was really ever so comfortable with that, with the way that was, you know, with that level of attention anyway, partially because you get this conflicted feeling where you don't want to ever dumb what you do down for your audience. That's when you don't have respect for them, but at the same time, you don't want to disappoint anybody and they have expectations of you. I hopefully, going out as myself gives me a little bit more freedom to do those things. And so, you know, if people had really fond memories of the band, it doesn't mess with those, really, you know. I used to do a lot of impressions, but I'm grossly out of practice now.
Frank settled down out in the valley. And he threw his wild ears on a nail that he left in his, a nail that he drove through his wife's forehead. Sold used office furniture out there on San Fernando Road.
And he, you know, and Tom Waits has all those voices, you know, the
waltzing, you go waltzing Matilda with me, and I'm an innocent victim of a blinded alley, and I'm tired of all these soldiers here.
He always has that fall off, whatever.